In her letters to him, she called him Angel Ears. Why Angel Ears, I asked her, in Ward 33 Psychiatry, JJ Hospital. She turned her cool green eyes on me and smiled. For a moment, her fingers stopped playing with the worn-out sheet that was covering her. Haven't you noticed? His ears are the sweetest thing about him. They look like bits of bacon curled up from too much frying. I had never thought of my father's ears. But later that evening, as he stood in the kitchen and cooked for me and my sister, scraping at a fry up of potatoes, I saw that his ears were indeed unusual. What was the first time that she had noticed his ears? Was it part of her falling in love with him? Or did it happen in the hypersensitive moments that followed? And when she called him by that name the first time, did he respond immediately? He probably did, without asking why. They could be like that sometimes. It intrigues me, love. Especially theirs, which seems to have been full of codes and rituals, almost all of them devised by her. She also called him Mambo and Augie March, but almost never by his given name, Agostinho. He called her Imelda, which was her name, and sometimes Beloved. She had another name for him, Limb of Satan, LOS. I asked her about that late one night, when the two of us smoked together on the balcony of our small flat in a city of small flats. Behind us, the one bedroom, hall, kitchen was quiet. In front of us, the side of a tenement rose like a cliff face. Two trees were framed in between the buildings, and in the foliage of one, a tube light flickered erratically. She started laughing, a harsh scrape of sound that might belong in a brothel. "Because he was always tempting me to sin," she said. "Who was?" Susan, my sister, was awake. She fitted herself into the balcony, waving a hand at the cloud of smoke we were producing. "Your father. It's not a sin if you're married, is it?" "It's always a sin according to the Holy Roman Catholics." "That can't be true." "Can it not? I think you're only supposed to do it if you want babies. I wanted 4 babies. But His Honor said, then you pay for the other 2. That, as they say, was that. And I have to give the other 26 away. 26? Susan and I looked at each other. Were there hordes of siblings that we knew nothing about? "I gave them straight out of my womb," she explained. "I could always tell when it had happened. I'd hear a click and I would know I'm pregnant again. And I'd pray to Our Lady to take the poor wee thing and give it to someone else who wanted a child. Maybe one of those women who buy wax babies to offer the said lady at Mahi." "So you'd have," I ventured. "Abortions? No, what do you take me for? I just climb down 5 stairs and jump 6. "Jump down the stairs? 6 steps and land with a thump 6 times to shake those poor little mites from their moorings.